You've likely heard of the concept, flipping the classroom. But what exactly does that mean? Why would you want to do it? And how exactly do you get started? The purpose of flipping the classroom is to help teachers make use of that precious face-to-face classroom time and use it for interacting with students and checking for understanding as they practice and apply what has been taught. If teachers could provide their direct instruction ahead of time, more time could be spent applying and extending the lesson. Basically, it works this way. Instead of having all the students sit and listen to a lecture or watch a video during class time, teachers would provide that video or a video of their lecture and make it available to their students to watch and review as homework. At school, students complete the activities they would normally do at home, but with a teacher in the room who can ensure quality practice, check for understanding, and give instant feedback. This works well when all students have access to the internet and technology tools at home. What happens to those who don't have that access? In that case, teachers can make the video lectures and resources available to students in centers-based instruction, or have them watch them as independent work in the classroom. Let's take a look at some ways you can get moving toward a flipped environment using resources already available to you. Have you ever been in a professional development session where you wish you could just pause your presenter or even rewind them to hear something repeated? Think of a time when your students may have felt the same way with the lesson you were presenting. Now think of how many interruptions can derail even the simplest lesson.
I have to go to the bathroom.
If you flip your lecture by recording it and posting it online, you can eliminate interruptions and students can simply rewind you to review parts they need to hear repeated. What do you need to get started? You'll need a recording device. This could be a phone, digital camera, an iPad, anything that can record video and sound and save it as a file you can post online. Situate yourself next to a whiteboard or some chart paper. Set up your camera on a tripod or stand about 6 to 10 feet away from you, so students watching your video will feel like they are sitting in the front row. If you don't feel comfortable running back and forth to start and stop the camera, you might want to ask a colleague or student to help run the camera for you. Speak directly to your device and present your lecture. Be sure to incorporate illustrations just as you would in front of real students. Oh, and one more thing. If you have fun with your presentation, your students will too.
Now, this is supposed to be.
Here's an example video lecture by Lodge McCammer.
Now, those are so small that we can't see them with our eyes. But
notice how close he is to the camera so the microphone can clearly pick up his voice. He also prepared his visuals ahead of time, so we don't have to wait for him to write them out. This way, he can move through his lecture quickly and efficiently.
This is supposed to be an ice cube right here. So what happens when the temperature increases and goes up, this ice cube is going to melt, and we've all seen this before.
In this example, these teachers work together using chart paper.
Learning about the water cycle. So, let me teach you a little song to get you going. Water travels in a cycle, yes it does.
Woo, woo!
Water travels in a cycle, yes it does.
Woo, woo!
It goes up as evaporation, forms clouds as condensation, then it falls as precipitation, yes it does.
And seepage runoff. Seepage runoff.
Notice the enthusiasm? No students will be falling asleep during this lecture. Here are some tips for making flipped lecture videos for your students. Video lectures should not be longer than about 7 minutes. If you have something longer than that, break it up into separate videos. Think how Discovery breaks their videos into segments for easy viewing and reviewing. Prepare your visuals ahead of time. This will help keep your videos short and help you remember what you want to say. Don't freak out if your video is not perfect. Your first attempt may feel awkward and uncomfortable, and may take longer to make than you expect. But the more you make, the better you'll get, and the quicker you'll be able to make them. Once your video is done, you can post it online and assign it to your students. You may also be able to use it over again next year. Paper slide videos are often described as the place where low-tech and high-tech collide. They're simple one-take videos that utilize paper, markers, and a recording device. First, you write out what you plan to say. Then, create visuals to go with it. And put those visuals in order. Set up a camera and press record. As you speak, move the paper so the visuals follow along with your words. It's just that simple. Here's one example. This teacher used a paper slide video to explain a difficult concept to her students.
That's 1/5 or 1/5.
Students watching this video can easily pause and replay it if they need to review the concept, instead of making the teacher repeat it and re-explain it.
An easy way to do this is to find an equivalent fraction that is a power of 10.
This leaves her free to help and assess other students in the class.
I see that if I take my denominator 5 and multiply by 2, I get 10.
Paper slide videos are also a great way for students to show what they know. In these examples, students were instructed to explore a key concept using Discovery Education videos, audio clips, and interactives. Then, they broke into groups and each group created a paper slide video explaining a different area of focus around that key concept. Even primary students can make a paper slide video, like this one that showcases student writing. Here's another example from Lodge McCammon.
Here are some simple and powerful strategies that can be used to activate student learning during the class period.
Notice how, instead of using sheets of paper, he uses a series of cutout images, moving them in and out of the frame to explain his concept.
If students create one-take videos during class time, it challenges...
And here's another example. This one was created to go with one of Lodge's 50 state songs, which are available through Discovery Education.
...by Charles II to repay a debt of loyalty, but oh, William Penn was embarrassed and did contend, stating people will think I named it after me.
That with a little practice, who knows, maybe you or your students could be making awesome paper slide videos like this.
Liberty from Philadelphia and
if you would like to see a full version of these and other paper slide videos, check out the links and resources that accompany this interactive training.
The eastern border is 57 miles.
Are you shy and don't like to see your face on the big screen? Or perhaps your drawing skills couldn't win you a game of Pictionary even if your life depended on it? Then my friend, screencasting is for you. Imagine yourself in front of a class sharing content from your computer. It could be a presentation, a website, or perhaps you're demonstrating how your students can use a particular web tool. Screencasting lets you record whatever is on your screen along with your voice explaining what to do, and it's perfect for that student who misses class or needs to review what you shared at home. Depending on your computer platform, there are some simple effective tools for recording your voice and screen and saving it as a video you can share online. For Windows and Mac users, there's a web tool called Screencast-O-Matic. This tool works right in your web browser. To begin recording your screen, just click Start Recording. You can select the old recorder, but note that it requires Java, so it may have troubles running in some web browsers like Google Chrome. Or if you are using it for the first time, you can download and install a newer app that will record your screen. Once you're set up, you just select the area of the screen you want to record and start recording. When you're finished, you can publish your recording to a video file that you can download. Note that the free version of Screencast-O-Matic will not let you record more than 15 minutes and will put a Screencast-O-Matic logo at the bottom of all your videos. Before you use Screencast-O-Matic for the first time, you should probably watch the demo video to get an idea of how it works. If you need more help using the app, click Help to access a collection of help videos. If you're a Mac user, you also have the option to use QuickTime to record your screen. Click on QuickTime Player, and you'll notice the QuickTime Player menu at the top. To record your screen, go to File, and select New Screen Recording. The Screen Recording button will appear. When you're ready to record, click Record. Click to start recording the whole screen, or click and drag to select just part of the screen that you want to record. When you're ready to start recording, click the Start Recording button. When you're done, go up to the top of the screen and click the Stop Recording button. A window containing what you just recorded will appear on top of your screen. Here you can play it back to review what you did, or if you like it, go to File and Save, name your file, and you can save it for sharing with your students. If you'd like to record your screen on a Chromebook, you'll need the Snagit app. Go to the Chrome Web Store and add the Snagit app to Chrome. But before you can record, you'll also need to install the Snagit extension. In order to record your screen on a Chromebook, you need both. Once it's installed and you're ready to record your screen, click on the extension in your toolbar. If you want to record your screen, click on Screen, and you'll also need to make sure that your microphone is enabled if you'd also like to record your voice. Chrome will probably ask you for permission to do this. After clicking Screen, you'll get to select what you want to record. The internal display records your entire Chromebook screen, or you can select just the tab you're on. When you click Share, you'll start recording. While you're recording, it will tell you that Snagit is sharing your screen. When you're done recording, just click on Stop. After you stop, it will sync the capture, and you'll want to go up to the top and give your video a name. After you've named your video, go down to the bottom corner and click on the three dots, and you will get to choose if you want to get a Google Drive link to your video, send it to YouTube, or if it's short enough, you can even save it as an animated GIF. After you've selected Google Drive, the video that you've recorded will appear in your Google Drive. No matter which app you use, once your screen recording is saved as a video file, it's ready to be shared.